1992, the end of 1992, it was Brother Azad who approached me at my brother's place once. He was visiting my brother Hassan, the late Marhum Hassan Sayed. And I happened to be in the area, and he's given me a book to read. Then I was guided. And I didn't pay much interest because I just thought it was just one of those books to read. And yes, in 1992 was the first time that I encountered, I got introduction to the Shia Islam. Me a book to read, then I was guided. And I didn't pay much interest because I just thought it was just one of those books to read. And yes. Allahumma salli alayhi, Allahumma salli alayhi. I started reading the book the very same night that he's given it to me, and in fact I completed the book the same very same night. And when I started to read things in that book, it went exactly against the grain of my thought, is that this is not what I've learned in my madrasa days. And I believed at that point in time is that I knew quite a bit about Islam, and only after reading the book did I realize how little I knew about Islam. And then I started to investigate, and there was a particular hadith, a hadith of Fadak that I read, and that started my investigation. And then I wanted to see how true it was that Bibi Fatima Salamun Alayha has faced all these atrocities in life. And at that point in time, when I authenticated this hadith, especially from the school of thought that I've come from, and I found that to be true, then I said, shukr to my Allah that you have guided me onto the right.
We delved deeper and we started scratching to establish what is it behind this political movement, only to discover that there was an ideological force which was in fact the school of Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salam.
I didn't know what school of thought I followed. All I knew is that we were along colleagues who said that we are Ashik Rasul, and that's all I knew, that we should stand for Salam, we should read our Salah, and that to me was my Islam. And later, after studying the school of Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salatu wasalam, did I realize that I followed the Barelvi school of thought.
The foundation, the inspiration for this revolution came from the revolution of Imam Hussein alayhi salam.
When you embraced the school of Ahlul Bayt, did you have much difficulty in practicing the faith? Did you have problems from the family or the wider community? What was your experience in the early years of being a Shia?
I think the day that I've authenticated Hadith of Fadak, I was not fearful for any person I came across. I confronted every single ulama that I knew and wanted to know exactly, is this true or not? And when I realized that they couldn't give me answers and they were playing hide and seek, then I realized that there was much to it. And that's what made me even more stronger. So as we gained momentum, my family actually split in two. So they are lovers of Ahlul Bayt, and then the half of my family started to follow the school of Ahlul Bayt alayhimus salatu wasalam, and the other half, my blood brothers, were actually against me. So my family basically is split into two, because they regard me, because the ulama tell them that our school of thought is kufr. So they keep away from basically myself. It was very difficult. The first few years were extremely difficult. Remember, it was just a handful of us that had to face the entire community. And when you greeted your fellow brother, Assalamu alaikum, he would not greet you back because he thought you were a kafir. And those things brought tears to our eyes. We had to endure those pain up to this very time when you want to reflect on the past. People treated you like, you know, you were so alone. You were so alone. There was not another Shia brother that was in the vicinity, nor anybody that would lend that support into saying, brother, chill, everything will be okay. We were alone. We just had to endure that pain. Shukar to Afosa, Maulana Aftab Haider, that he, when we met him at a later stage, he was the one that was our motivating factor. Brother, hang in there, hang in there. These things happened to Imam Hussein alayhi salam, and basically my strength, when I read about Bibi Zainab Salamun Alayha, and every time when you take the name of Bibi Zainab Salamun Alayha, that is my strength. When Bibi Zainab Salamun Alayha stood in the court of Yazid and spoke like a father eloquently and defended Imam Hussein alayhi salam and the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wasalam up to this day. This is my motivating factor. And this is the story that I tell my kids. And I say from the bottom of my heart, to stand up anywhere in any part of the world and scream that I am the lover of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wasalam. And this is what I have inculcated in my family, my wife, my children, and whoever I can. And what the challenges that we face today and what gets me going is that we will find a simple excuse wherever it is in the community. The moment there is an excuse to talk about the love for the Ahlul Bayt alayhi salatu wasalam, we will stop anything we're doing just to tell people, look at what is out there. Look at what is out there, what you are missing. And this is what keeps us so energized day in and day out.
Absolutely wonderful moment. And I mean, all the what happened all those years ago, you remember it, but you don't even worry about it anymore. And those friends that rejected you, you don't even think about them because you got a much better family. A family that means so much more to you in every respect, every socially, spiritually, in every way. And I just feel that we can just grow and grow and grow from here. And I can't wait for our mosque in Cape Town. Allahumma salli alayhi. Allahumma salli alayhi. Allahumma salli alayhi. Allahumma salli alayhi.
Soil, the sand, the dust that is around Ahmad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The one who smells the sand, merely smelling the sand in his hand, should not smell anything evil in his life. Hadi Fatima. If you want to learn from the madrasa of Fatima, here is the madrasa of Fatima to Zahra. Mada ala man shamma turbata Ahmadin, alla yashimma mada zamani gawaliya, subbat alayya masa'ibun law annaha. صبت على الأيام سرنا ليالي You have to know what was going on through the heart of Fatima al-Zahra when she lost her father, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he passed away. She said, "Ya father, masa'ib, disasters came on me because of your departure. If these disasters were poured on the night, it would turn day." Hadi Fatima al-Zahra, radiallahu anha.
إن مستقر فسوف تعلمون من يأتيه عذاب يخزيه ويحل عليه عذاب مقيم ثم رمت بطرفها نحو الأنصار فقالت يا معشر النقيبة وأعضاد الملة وحضنة الإسلام ما هذه الغميزة في حقي والسنة عن غلامتي أما كان رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم أبي يقول المرء يحفظ في ولده سرعان ما أحدثتم وعجلان ذا إهالة ولكم طاقة بما أحاول وقوة على ما أطلب وأزاول أتقولون مات محمد فخطب جليل استوسع وهنوه واستنهر فتحه وانفتق رتقه وأظلمت الأرض لغيبته وكسفت النجوم لمصيبته وأكدت الآمال وخشعت الجبال وأضيع الحريم وأزيلت الحرمة عند مماته فتلك والله النازلة الكبرى والمصيبة العظمى لا مثلها نازلة ولا بائقة عاجلة أعلن بها كتاب الله جل ثناؤه في أفنيتكم في ممساكم ومصبحكم هتافا وصراخا وتلاوة وألحانا ولقبله ما حل بأنبيائه ورسله حكم فصل وقضاء حكم وانتظروا إنا منتظرون
قل لا أسألكم عليه أجرا إلا المودة في القربى